So Texas for a rally tonight about his border wall.
Meanwhile, new developments. Lawmakers have reached an agreement in principle to avoid a second government shutdown on Friday. Natalie Brand has the latest.
President Trump held a campaign rally in El Paso, Texas on Monday night, and he brought the battle over the border wall with him.
I don't know, you heard, right? Today, we started a big, beautiful wall right on the Rio Grande.
His rally comes just days before the threat of a second partial government shutdown. El Paso's Republican Mayor Dee Margo disputed President Trump's claim that the border barrier made El Paso safer, pointing out that crime began falling before the fence went up.
We were safe before the border wall went up, or I call it the fence.
Not far from Mr. Trump's rally, El Paso native and former Congressman Beto O'Rourke, who's said to be considering a 2020 run, held a rally of his own.
We stand for the Constitution of the United States of America and against emergency national security declarations.
Over on Capitol Hill, key members of the House and Senate say they have reached an agreement in principle tonight on border security to avoid a second government shutdown.
The latest sticking point centered around the number of ICE detention beds, which Democratic leaders want to cap.
This is a poison pill that no administration, not this one, not the previous one, would or should ever accept.
Lawmakers must pass a deal that the president will sign by Friday night or face another partial government shutdown. Natalie Brand, CBS News, The White House.
U.S. Senator John Tester, who serves on the Border Committee, says, quote, our bipartisan committee did its job and crafted a compromise that will help secure our borders and keep the government open. Montanans deserve that kind of certainty from their lawmakers.